Data doesn't sit in one convenient location. In a hybrid cloud world, there's databases on premises, applications and analytics platforms running in the cloud, and edge devices collecting sensor data. For some organizations, the most effective way to integrate their data is to process it where it lives. This is where the value of remote engines comes into play. Remote engines are execution environments that you deploy and manage in your own systems, either on premises or in your cloud environments, to run data integration and data quality tasks. They're essentially computation resources that you control, allowing you to keep data integration workloads close to your data sources. We can think about data integration as how water is processed in a city. Typically, water is processed at a central processing plant. In this analogy, think about remote engines like the water filter I have in my apartment. Sure, the city treats the water at the main plant, but having that filter right in my apartment means I can do the filtering behind my own walls. So what makes remote engines special? Picture this. You deploy a containerized application running in your data plane. You can deploy this in your virtual private cloud, on-premises data center, or in any cloud environment. Inside that container, let's say we're using Kubernetes for now, you can have what we call the conductor pod, which orchestrates and manages your jobs, as well as several compute pods, which actually handle the workload. The breakthrough is the separation of design time and runtime. You design your jobs in a control plane or one fully managed centralized platform, but the execution happens on the remote engine. A quick example could be the data plane over here on the right, where I have my remote engine, and what can be referred to as the control plane over here on the left, where I design and manage my jobs. So let's say I have a simple ETL job where I have two sources being combined into one with some transformations in the middle, and I'm writing to a target. What we have is the control plane manages the compilation of these jobs in the code, and then sends that information down to the data plane where that actually gets executed. This is a simple explanation of how organizations can use the control plane to design jobs and a data plane to actually run the jobs. So let's break down why this architecture is becoming essential for modern data operations. The first is cost efficiency. Cloud providers charge egress fees when data leaves their environment. This adds up when you're moving millions of rows daily. Remote engines eliminate this by processing the data in the same cloud as where it lives, with use cases including running data quality rules where the data resides, leading to a substantial cost savings. The second is performance. Instead of moving data sets across networks, you can execute data integration jobs close to the data and as close to the data as you'd like. Regardless of if you're running a single job to hundreds of thousands, the compute pods can auto-scale to handle the workload. They can scale up, and then once the workload's completed, scale back down just to have one or two compute pods running. The workload is distributed intelligently among the compute pods, allowing for dynamic processing to handle bursts in workloads over time. You can also tune parameters that you control for dynamic, efficient processing right where your data lives. The third benefit, and perhaps the most important, is security. Sensitive data like financial records, healthcare information, or proprietary research often cannot leave its current environment or locality. So remote engines allow you to process this data without ever moving beyond your security perimeter, as they can be deployed behind what we call here as the firewall. This allows you to create secure connections to your sources and targets without data ever leaving behind your wall. Just like how my apartment handles filtering and data processing within my controlled space, remote engines deliver these three key benefits as well. So data security, because I can filter my data behind my own wall. Cost, because I do not need to pay for these egress and ingress fees, and I can avoid those charges. and also high performance by avoiding bottlenecks with the water service. The beauty is that regardless of where they're deployed, you manage everything from a single control plane. With remote engines, you design jobs once and run them anywhere. The last question you might be asking is, the benefit of software as a service is that I don't have to administer anything. So how does that work in the remote engine? So because remote engines are containerized runtimes, they're easier to update than the traditional infrastructure. This is because traditional infrastructure often requires downtime, complex migration procedures, or complete system rebuilds. But with containers, you simply patch the container with a new version, and you can update the container image, and the conductor will manage rolling out the compute pods with minimal disruption. Once everything is running smoothly on the new version, it shuts down the old pods, so your data processing never stops. Just like how I replace my water filter when it's convenient for me, you control when to refresh your remote engines without disrupting operations. Remote engines represent a fundamental shift from the old hub and spoke model of data processing to a hybrid deployment pattern that respects where your data naturally lives. You get processed data exactly where and when you need it, while keeping costs down and security up.